One of the creators of Mary Hartman, as well as one of the writers of the Carol Burnett Show. She wrote the book Sheila Levine is Dead and Living in New York. And this is her latest book right here. It's called A Little Bit Married. Please welcome a very funny woman, Gail Parent.
Would you welcome writer Gail Parent?
They're with us, Gail Parent and Penny Psalms. They're called the wackiest, the best writing team of comedy shows at the moment in America.
And Gail wrote a book that currently is a number three bestseller in Los Angeles called Sheila Levine is Dead and Living in New York. Would you welcome Gail Parent?
Our next guest is an Emmy Award-winning writer for The Carol Burnett Show. She wrote Mary Hartman, and a raft of other screenplays and books. Her last book is called A Little Bit Married. She's Gail Parent.
Joining us now is the most successful comedy writer. She's written for Carol Burnett, that show, for a number of years, Mary Tyler Moore Show, and, of course, for Barbara Streisand, she wrote The Main Event, as well as authoring the best-selling novel Sheila Levine is Dead and Living in New York. This is her latest novel, The Best Laid Plans. Can't wait to hear what this is about, but welcome Gail Parent.
Tribune Entertainment presents Kelly Lang and Gail Parent, one of the groundbreaking creators of Mary Hartman, best-selling author, a funny lady with some questions of her own.
Do you think that you could ever have a completely faithful relationship?
Oh, absolutely.
With me?
Over the years, Gail has written for some of Hollywood's funniest women. She's written for Carol Burnett, Mary Tyler Moore, Rhoda. Now she's making the Golden Girls funny.
You know, I'm tired of doing that. I'm tired of making everybody else funny. I want to say the funny things myself.
Thank you for being a friend.
Oh, morning, Ma.
Dorothy, when was the last time you had sex?
That's a very personal question.
That long, huh?
See that glow?
What glow? Do you mean the waxy yellow buildup?
What do you mean? That can't be a waxy yellow buildup. Read the can.
Mary, you're looking at a waxy yellow buildup.
No, I'm not. I am looking at a label that says, that can't be.
Mary, I'm your sister. And I'm telling you, it's not a waxy buildup there. It's a waxy buildup there.
You know, these people, I mean, they turn out about a million cans a week. I mean, who am I supposed to listen to, you?
Waxy yellow buildup.
It is a little yellow, isn't it?
Certainly is.
Why is it that you two are particularly adept and perhaps drawn toward working with superstar women?
Kenny likes them, and I am one.
I see.
Miss Henderson, Miss Lepore, yeah. Miss Burnett, I'm sorry, we won't be using you.
Three Girls Three, starring Debbie Allen, Ellen Foley, and Mimi Kennedy.
What shows have you written together?
Well, Steve Allen was our first one. Then Carol Burnett we did for 4 years.
I did for five.
Yeah.
And Kenny did it
You
for
went on
four.
Your own? Your side on your
The last, Kenny, we had a fight every year about whether we were going back.
I said, I can't
so
think
personal.
Of another idea. I can't.
Really?
I can't.
And I kept saying, all right, I'm going back without you.
And was it very different to be without him?
Yes.
It yes.
It must I have. Got an Emmy and he didn't.
The network was not 100% behind it. They thought that, again, you know, all these variety shows that were on, none of them had a female lead. And they really expected it to fail. She showed them.
Welcome to our first show that we're doing. I'm real excited and very, very happy that you're all with us tonight. Looks like we got a nice...
The one of Mrs. Higgins is much more interesting than Eliza's in many ways. I mean, even though she's not the female lead, it's a part with depth and true contemporary resonance. And it's the one that I wanted.
Good, because it's the one you got.
There's a scene in there where the characters are talking about condoms and about safe sex.
Again, when we first wrote it, it used to be Hollywood had movies that were 7 years in the making. Now they're 7 years in the writing. When we first wrote it, we were talking about herpes. And the scene about AIDS, where they actually talk about AIDS, and the scene where they both come to bed with condoms, was put in, they were both put in right before the movie was shot. Uh-huh. And we thought that we are doing a date, we are doing it minute by minute, we have got to include this.
Tony, you want to talk about it?
Talk about what?
What we haven't been talking about. The big question of the day.
You're safe with me.
I am.
Yes. I have a triple A rating. I mean, you could eat off me.
I probably will.
Yeah. I'll take that on. Speak up!
Sometimes it's tough to hear. Good morning, Mr. Pittman.
Good morning, Miss Cross.
Were you the defendant's next-door neighbor at the time of the murder?
Yes, I was.
And did you hear a scream at approximately 4:28 a.m. on Monday, June 12th, 1995?
Yes, I did.
And did you run into apartment 14D?
Yes, I did.
Do I look fat?
I object. Miss Cross's weight has nothing to do with this case.
I'm trying to establish the witness's perspective on size, Your Honor.
Objection sustained.
Approximately how long did it take you to illegally enter your neighbor's apartment?
About 60 seconds.
Does my hair look big?
Your Honor, the defense is asking questions on her own behalf.
Why do you keep asking this man about how you look?
I thought we were pursuing the truth in this case, Your Honor. Does my hair look like a basket on sale at Pier 1?
Objection!
Gail, thank you very much for being here. Nice meeting you. We'll be back.
There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing. Everything the traffic will allow.